My question is, okay, so there's a hadith about whoever recites Ayatul Kursi, there's nothing that can prevent him from going to Jannah except death.
True.
Like Alhamdulillah, after every salat I recite Ayatul Kursi. But I was wondering, does that mean like that I'm guaranteed that I'm going to be in Jannah, or like does it depend on the things that I do? Because like what if, let's say, an example, someone does major sins, what happens then?
That's a very good question. So in the seventh hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man qara'a آية الكرسي دبر كل صلاة لم يمنعه من دخول الجنة إلا النار. And the meaning is as you heard. One who recites آية الكرسي after every fard namaz or prayer or salah, nothing stops him from entering paradise but death. Which means if he were to die soon after reciting Ayat al-Kursi, he shall enter paradise. So I've now is saying, what about somebody who is involved in major sins? All the ahadith which talk about virtuous deeds, virtuous acts, virtuous sayings, recitations, supplications, like Sayyidul Istighfar, if one happen to recite this sincerely, knowing its meaning and repenting, then he's going straight to Jannah. But if one recites verbally and he's still involved in major sins, as you've mentioned, and he did not repent, then this person will enter Jannah. But huwa ala khatar al-mashi'ah. He's taking the risk of having to be purified from the sin first. We all have to understand that a person who simply says, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, shall enter paradise no matter what he did. But if he did good and his sins were minor and were forgiven, he will enter Jannah without any punishment. And some people will enter Jannah without even reckoning. But if a person said La ilaha illallah and used to do Hajj and Umrah, but he was involved in sins, particularly sins related to others, human rights, then no doubt that this person will be purified from his or sins first before having to enter Jannah. So it mandates the entry to Jannah. Yet there is some hanging matters that needs to be taken care of, which Allah may forgive and may pardon, even if they were major sins. And Allah may punish for, and in this case, the person has to be purified in an-nar wal-iyadu billah. So then what is the benefit of the hadith? The benefit of the hadith is to encourage you to gain all the virtuous deeds and supplications, like reciting the ayah after the salah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Suhaib, any person who does a good deed, فَخُتِمَ لَهُ بِهِ دَخْلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Yani a person who is praying and he died in his sujood, this person will enter Jannah. A person who is fasting, and while fasting, he died. Or he broke his fast, then he died. آخِرُ عَمَلِهِ, the last deed of his was fasting. He shall enter Jannah. Because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ. So that will be a factor that announces that this person is saved. But I've recited Ayat al-Kursi, and I went back to smoke, or I sat with the friends and we got involved in backbiting, or I'm working in a conventional bank and I'm earning riba. So that's an aspect that needs to be taken care of by itself. Either you repent and you quit, then inshallah you will be eligible to enter Jannah, because Allah the Almighty said, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Surah Hud, Allah the Almighty says, أَقِمُ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَي النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. What does it mean that وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ? If you pray in the morning, if you pray in the evening, الصَّلَاةَ, the namaz, expiates the sins which were committed in between. Minor sins, not the major ones. So for the major ones, I know that I was working in haram, earning haram. You quit, you regret, the sin will be forgiven. And Allah the Almighty also said in Surah An-Nisa, إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَنُدْخِلْكُمْ مُدْخَلًا كَرِيمًا. Guess what, Suhaib? This is now not an act of force that if you do, or a supplication, if you recite, you enter Jannah. Simply Allah says, for mere avoiding the major sins, Allah will remit your minor sins and will admit you to the noble entry, which is Al-Jannah. Why? Because of avoiding the major sins. May Allah guide us to what is best.